अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल होम ट्यूटर बाय सुनैरा। उम्मीद है आप लोग खैरियत से होंगे। अच्छा जी, मैं फिजियोलॉजी का लेक्चर स्टार्ट कर रही हूँ। सबसे पहले इंट्रोडक्शन टू फिजियोलॉजी, ये मैंने गाइडन से उठाया है, कुछ जो है वो नेट से उठाया हुआ है, ठीक है। तो फिजियोलॉजी बेसिकली हमें पता होने से पहले पता होना चाहिए कि हमारे पास जो है वो कौन आपके पास जो फिजियोलॉजी को डील कर रहे होते हैं वो क्या चीज़ें होती हैं। तो सबसे पहले अगर हम बात करते हैं फिजियोलॉजी की, तो फिजियोलॉजी हमारे पास क्या है, दैट इज़ द साइंस दैट सीक्स टू एक्सप्लेन द फिजिकल एंड केमिकल मैकेनिज्म दैट आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर ओरिजिन डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्रेशन ऑफ द लाइफ। मतलब लाइफ किस तरह बनी, किस तरह डिवेलप हुई और किस तरह वो फर्दर प्रोग्रेस हो रही है, दैट डील्स विद द फिजियोलॉजी। अगर हम किसी ह्यूमन सिस्टम की बात करते हैं तो हमने अगर ह्यूमन ही को फोकस करना है तो वो दैट इज़ ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी। इसमें बेसिकली हमने उस मैकेनिज्म्स को देखना है जो ह्यूमन बॉडी को रन कर रहे होते हैं, दैट इज़ बेसिकली ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी। वी हैव अ गोल टू स्टडी फिजियोलॉजी आफ्टरवर्ड्स दैट वी एक्सप्लेन द फिजियोलॉजी फिजिकल एंड केमिकल फैक्टर दैट रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द ओरिजिन डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्रेशन ऑफ द लाइफ। तो सिंपल हमारे पास क्या हुआ, फिजियोलॉजी इज द सिंपली द साइंस विच एक्सप्लेन आर डिफरेंट सिस्टम्स देयर फंक्शंस एंड हाउ दे हेल्प इन आर बॉडी फॉर देयर वर्किंग। नेक्स्ट कम टू द सेल, सेल बेसिकली अ बेसिक यूनिट ऑफ बॉडी। सिंपली वी कैन से दैट सेल इज अ स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ सेल एज वी स्टडी इन यूनिट क्लासेस। वी हैव डिफरेंट सेल्स, वी हैव डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स। सेल्स बेसिकली फॉर्म्ड बाय डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनेल्स, डिफरेंट मॉलिक्यूल्स, डिफरेंट यू कैन से दैट मैक्रोमोलिक्यूल, माइक्रोमोलिक्यूल, दीज फॉर्म द सेल्स। सेल्स कम्बाइंस टू फॉर्म अ टिश्यू एंड टिश्यू कम्बाइंस टू फॉर्म अ ऑर्गन एज वी स्टडी अर्लियर। सो दैट वी कैन से दैट सेल इज़ द बेसिक कंपोनेंट ऑफ द बॉडी। इफ वी से दैट बॉडी इज नथिंग विदाउट सेल। डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स इन आर बॉडी परफॉर्मिंग डिफरेंट फंक्शन, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एज यू कैन सी इन दिस स्लाइड, आर बी सीज रेड ब्लड सेल्स help in transporting of oxygen from lungs to tissue. That is 25 trillion in types of cells in our human being body. 75 trillion additional cells other than RBCs for different function. Mean to say, we can say that different types of cells performing different function in our body. Next come to the extracellular fluid. What is extracellular fluid? Extracellular fluid is basically the fluid present outside of the cell. If we have a cell, and cell inside of the cell is the intracellular fluid and outside of that cell is called extracellular fluid, and we have 60% of our body is filled up with the extracellular fluid, including intracellular fluid as well. And the total fluid our body covered as 60%. Next, as you can see in this picture, we have intracellular fluid which is present in our cells, and outside of the cell that is interstitial fluid, or we can say that extracellular fluid. Differentiate between the extracellular fluid and intracellular fluid, there is a little bit difference between these two types of fluid. As you can see in this slide, sodium chloride and bicarbonate ions are present in extracellular fluid, while intracellular fluid contain potassium, magnesium and phosphate ion. This is a simply difference between the extracellular fluid and intracellular fluid. Next come to the main topic, that is homeostasis. Before this topic we studied about the cell, their fluids, and definition of physiology which we have started today. Homeostasis basically is the maintenance of our body environment with respect to the external environment. If there will be difference, if there will be change in the temperature outside, our body try to maintain our body temperature with respect to the external temperature, and that is basically a homeostasis. Homeostasis may be of thermoregulation type. If it deals with the temperature, it is called thermoregulation. It deals with the excretion. It deals with the osmoregulation. In this slide, we studied about the definition of homeostasis, that is maintenance of constant environment in the body is called homeostasis, and this terminology was given by Walter Cannon in 1929. Next come to the slide, we will study about the all the organs and tissues of the body perform different functions that help maintain these relatively constant conditions. For instance, the lungs provide oxygen to the extracellular fluid to replenish. Mean to say, this example, this is a little bit small example to justify the definition of homeostasis. If we have a shortage of oxygen, our body try to maintain our oxygen level by providing oxygen from different mechanisms by performing aerobic respiration. Comes to the next slide, that is extracellular fluid transport and mixing system, the blood circulatory system. Blood circulatory system is one of our body system which contain blood vessels and a pumping organ, that is heart. Extracellular fluid is transported through the body in two stages. The first stage is that movement of blood through the body in the blood vessels, mean to say the circulating fluid is traveling or circulating our blood vessels, and secondly that movement between the blood capillaries and intracellular spaces between the tissues. This is the simple diagrammatic representation about the circulatory system. As you can see that the right lung carry the deoxygenated blood from the right side of the heart, and the left side of lung distribute the send the oxygenated blood towards the heart, and heart then further distribute to the whole body. This is the origin of the nutrients in the extracellular fluid. We have different types of system like respiratory system. Respiratory system, if you can see in your Guyton book, respiratory system is basically contained, or if you can see in this picture, the topmost diagram is basically a respiratory system in which we have a lungs, and we have bronchi and bronchioles. Lungs contain alveoli, sacs of the air sacs in which the air comes from our nostrils, and they contain oxygen. Here will oxygen and carbon dioxide exchange. Carbon dioxide comes from our blood to the air, and oxygen comes in our blood from the alveoli. That is a respiratory system. This is the diameter or measurements of the alveoli, 0.4 to 2 micrometer. Then GIG tract, that is our gut, basically from mouth to anus, it is formed from the smooth muscles, and they contain different types of dissolved nutrients including carbohydrate, fatty acids and amino acids. Next to the musculoskeletal system, in which it provides motility for the protection against the adverse surrounding, skeletal muscles or skeletal systems provide basically support or posture toward the body. Next, liver and other organs that perform primarily metabolic functions. Liver, as you know, that liver provides the bile, and bile contain different types of enzymes, or you can see the material which help in digestion of our food. And that removal of metabolic end products from removal of carbon dioxide by lung, as I discussed earlier, that carbon dioxide and oxygen exchange in our lungs. Carbon dioxide added in air from our blood through alveolar sacs and capillary network which surround our alveoli, and oxygen comes out in blood from the air sacs. This is the removal of carbon dioxide, and kidneys remove the waste from our blood, our body, by filtering our blood. Next, GIT tract and digestive material, that is the GIT tract, and some waste products from metabolism eliminated in the feces. The fecal material is eliminated out through the GIT tract. And the liver help in detoxification or removal of different types of drugs and chemicals that are ingested. The liver secretes many of these waste into the bile to eventually eliminated into the feces. Next, these types of different types of tissues in our body: epithelial, connective, muscles, nerve, blood. And this diagram show that how our homeostasis work Organismic homeostasis include internal change or external change. If external change occurs, then our body how changes its internal change. Internal change results in loss of homeostasis. If internal change caused, then loss of homeostasis caused. But if it will be recovered, then we become well. And if it will not recover, then we become ill. Next control system of the body, that is digestive system, respiratory system, cardiovascular system, integumentary system, very important system, endocrine system including the hormones, and digestive system includes the GIT tract from mouth to anus, accessory parts, that is teeth, tongue, salivary glands, liver, gallbladder, pancreas, help in nutrition. And next, this diagram shows the digestive system include mouth, pharynx, esophagus, liver, stomach, large intestine, small intestine, alveoli, and that is anus. Next, this is the accessory parts, liver or gallbladder. Peristaltic movement is basically the slow wave-like movement which causes the movement of food in forward direction. That is continuous contraction and relaxation which help to food move forwardly. And additional enzymes and bile continue the food breakdown. This all you all already study in your intermediate sections. Respiratory system, air enters the body through the nose and mouth. We have bronchi, that is a main the tube leading from windpipe or trachea towards the bronchi, and bronchi further divided into bronchioles, and bronchioles further divided into small air sacs. These are called alveoli. This is the basically respiratory system, nasal passage, larynx, pharynx. Larynx basically voice box which cause our sounds, our voice. And then trachea leads into the bronchi, and bronchioles leads further in bronchioles and alveoli. Cardiovascular system, that is transport system of our body, consists of heart, pumping organ, blood, the circulating fluid, blood vessels, arteries, veins and capillaries. And then heart, that is a major part of our body, major organ of the body, four chambers, two atrias, two ventricles, then bicuspid, tricuspid valve, and the cardiac muscles are responsible for the formation of heart, epicardium, myocardium, these are the layers of the heart. And all of this, then blood is basically a fluid, circulating fluid formed of two components, formed elements including RBCs, leukocytes or platelets. Platelets basically is not a cell, these are cell fragments, and plasma is a basically fluid which form fluidity in our blood. Next, red blood cells, most abundant cells formed in bone marrow, contain hemoglobin, anemia, sickle cell anemia, if you studied in your intermediate or matric classes. Anemia is basically abnormal division of the, or you can say that abnormal growth of the RBCs in sickle shape by just you can say that mutation caused in beta chain of hemoglobin, which causes the shape of RBCs but from concave into the sickle shape. That is called anemia, which causes death. Next, leukocytes is basically serve as a protective function, causes our immunity strong by forming the antibodies against the germs or antigens which try to enter in our body or which we got entry in our body, produced in bone marrow and various organs of the body. Leukemia is basically a disorder of the leukocytes in which the abnormal division of white blood cells cause. If the white blood cells are not grow well or in normal range, you can say that, and then we have a definitely we cause we will face our immunity disorders or you can say that defending disorders, and at the end we maybe suffer from the very fatal diseases. And platelet basically these are the cell fragments which causes different types of function. For example it causes blood clotting. If we have some injury or something, we have cut from our body, it will be recovered by the clotting of the blood, so that blood will not clot further. Plasma, that is a fluid. 90% of water and 10% of plasma protein, fibrinogen, albumin. These are the different proteins found in our plasma. Blood plasma, urinary system contain kidneys. Kidneys contain different millions type of nephron, which causes the reabsorption of the water, reabsorption of the nutrients, and filter our blood and cause waste material separate from our blood. And urine formation is the basic one of the function of kidney. Next, endocrine system, which is Duclos' glands, and the pituitary glands is the master gland of the body. And the pituitary gland, inshallah, we will study further in detail. Next, nervous system, as you studied earlier in your junior classes or in previous classes, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous consists of brain and spinal cord. Skeleton system, function framework, and support, protection, storage, axial skeleton, appendicular skeleton. We have 206 bones in our body, and axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton, these are the two types of skeleton as you studied in your intermediate sections. And appendages, basically appendicular skeleton contains appendages, our forelimb, or you can say the hind limb, and axial skeleton, main axis of our the body. Muscular systems, including three types of muscles, skeleton, smooth, and cardiac. They have ability to contract so that we can easily move through skeleton system. They have ability to contract so that our heart become contract and relax and easily pump our blood and towards our body or away from our body. And ability to stretch so that we can easily move, or our organs become easily become empty or filled from the different nutrients. These top the three types of the muscles. Skeleton, smooth, and cardiac. Skeleton, straighted, single, or one or more nuclei found in per cell. Smooth muscles contain only one cell per nucleus. Does not contain any striations. Cardiac muscles, which have striations branched, and more than two cells are found. More than two types of nucleus, or one or more nucleus found in per cell. Immune system protection include our WBCs, lymph nodes, lymph vessels, lymphatic system, inshallah we will study in future in detail. Thymus gland, phagocytosis, that is the solid particles intake of the solid particle. Integumentary system, inshallah we have a second topic for discussion in next lecture, that is intake system. Intake system is basically contain a skin and accessory part, hair and nails, which are the basically first barrier for our external environment. Reproduction is the major or very important process through which any species can carry on their race. Then different types of excretory system, and that's it. Overall, this is the basically the topic of homeostasis, and homeostasis is basically about the maintenance of our internal environment with respect to their external environment. That's it. If there you have any question, then comment below and stay blessed. Goodbye.